Okay, so today the temperatures are climbing. And this is an unusual weather day for us, and I'm showing you a horizontal long Langstroth hive and normal activity in and out of the entrance here. But look at this beehive. This has come out of winter, and it had a late season swarm, so it had a very small entrance reducer so that they could defend themselves. But now, springtime, look at all the pollen that's piling in there. We're coming up on swarming season, so paying attention to landing boards and entrance reducers is really important to slow that process down. So I'm looking for a few things here. One, traffic jam. I've always said this, if there's a big traffic jam at your entrance, you have to open up that reducer. But I'm not going to put another wooden entrance reducer here. I'm going to put in screens, and I'll explain why in a minute. But the other thing is, this is the only colony that's producing any drones in any number. So what I like to do is look at all the other colonies and see what their drone counts are before I even think about doing something like a split. So for now, a split is premature. Even though we see these drones, I need to see drones from other colonies first, but I do want to slow down their desire to swarm out and maybe even keep them from swarming altogether. So there's a deep box on this 10 frame, and there's also a medium super on already. So the other thing we have to do to help slow down the swarming instinct is to pull this entrance reducer out and do two things. One, we're going to open the entrance reducer wider so there's more traffic with no traffic jam. And number two, I'm going to use a copper screen. And that's going to allow airflow, which gives them a greater sense of less congestion inside this hive. Now we're looking at another hive too. Again, tiny entrance reducer. That's because I did not expect these bees to make it through winter at all. They're a very tiny swarm that was an after swarm from a home that's about 10 miles from my house. And I didn't think they would make it, but because I installed them during prime robbing season at the end of the year, I needed a small entrance reducer, but look at them now. Now we're gonna have to use this wire screen. By the way, this mesh is sold as a rodent prevention because mice don't like to chew it. Rats don't like to chew it. It's pure copper. I have clippers there, and of course my entrance reducer puller here. We didn't have to smoke them because I'm gonna move really slow, and I'm gonna pull this entrance reducer out with this J hook here, J screw. If you wanna see how to put one of these together or what the components are, I will put a link down in the video description for you. It's very easy to make it. All I did was drill a quarter inch hole through this piece of wood, and then of course, look, we turn the screw and it gradually pulls out the entrance reducer. Sometimes those entrance reducers can be really gummed up and people like to hit them with the hive tool and put a screwdriver in there and crank them around. But you can rile up your bees. We don't have to do that. We can move nice and slow and use that to ease it out of there. And look, the bees don't even care. Again, we're not opening the hive right now, so I'm not worried about smoking. And look how that relieved the traffic jam there. Also, a lot more bees than you might have thought were wanting to get in and out through that tiny hole. So this is very timely. This is May 3rd. So normally within a week or two, we're looking at potential for swarms. So we're going to have to do some hive full inspections coming up. There's a little drone right in the middle there. And now we've got that copper mesh rolled up and just tucked in there. That's all we need to do. Let's go back to the other one here. Gonna do the same thing, but look at how tiny this entrance is. So I have a problem getting my J hook in, which I'm gonna show you in a minute. As when you go to put it in, look, that entrance is too small. So I just took it off of the wood altogether, gonna bring it in here at an angle, get it lined up, and then I'm gonna reattach my wooden piece, which is just a brace that I use to pull it out against the landing board. Now, if I had no landing boards, this method just wouldn't work. I'd have to have some kind of standoff built into the wood as well. So this works best when there is, of course, a small landing board. And then we'll just twist this one just as we did with the other. And again, no smoking, nothing to calm the bees. This is happening at 12:30 in the afternoon. Temperature outside is actually 70 degrees, if you can believe it. Now, Fred, why don't you just go ahead and split these colonies? Well, this one, for example, isn't producing any drones. So I look for an abundance of drones before I do any splits. The other thing is, tomorrow, that's right, we're gonna go right down to 39 degrees Fahrenheit. And we're gonna have a cold week ahead. So this is not the time for me anyway to be splitting colonies and risking that brood. So we're just going to pull this out. Look how smooth that happens. The bees are riding it. They don't care. And just as we did with the other colony, we are going to put in 100% copper screen. I'll put a link to that down in the video description. Again, this stuff is for stuffing around pipes and tubes and things in your house to keep rodents from getting in, so it works great for that. Buy a nice big roll of it. It also can work for filters and screens and venting. And here I use it as an entrance reducer. This fits any size hive, including those flow hives, which have the little thin entrances. You can just roll up screen and stuff it in there. Now we're going to restore traffic, and look at all the propolis that's coming in there and pollen. That really deep rosy stuff that just went in there is likely propolis. And look at the flood of bees that are going. Now part of this is because some of them were standing off and hovering around because I was in front of the hive pulling their entrance reducer and putting in these copper screens. But just look at the pollen. The thing is, we're also not full on into the nectar flow yet. There's an abundance of pollen, and sure, the dandelions have opened up, so they are getting some dandelions, but the real nectar flow is coming up. So, second to third week of May is prime swarm season. That's when we want to head off those swarms and start pulling apart and maybe thinking about doing some splits. In the meantime, if you've got a congested colony, make sure that the venting, the landing board, the entrance is open, and that you've got at least one honey super on so that they have room to put their resources. Otherwise, they're going to want to swarm. And once they start and start building the swarm cells, there might be little to nothing you can do about it. Even when you split the colony, they may still swarm. If they've already built queen cells, and if those things are looking like they're about to be capped, you might be getting into this a little too late. So this is a time to really pay attention. And again, this is the strongest one. This is the one with the most drones in it. So because that's not the same throughout my apiary, I'm going to hold off. So I hope you learned something here. Ventilate your hive. Open those entrance reducers if there's a big traffic jam on them. Remember, we're going into the first nectar flow of the year, and that's when we're going to get in a period of rapid expansion. So it's time to pay attention to those colonies. And coming up, we're going to do a step-by-step hive inspection, and probably it's going to be this green hive here because it is so full, and I'm probably also going to turn that into a split, but I'm going to share what I find inside this colony. So thanks for watching. I hope you're having a great weekend, and wherever you are, I hope the weather is cooperating. We have the risk of having snow tomorrow. Light snow, of course, it'll melt right off, 38 degrees or something like that. So I hope you learned something. Thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you during my question and answer videos on Friday. Have a great day.